Hi, my name is Amy Culver, and I'm a nurse here at Mercy of Northwest Arkansas. My dad, Butch Bollinger, was admitted to the COVID ICU on December 12th, 2020, and placed on a ventilator just 2 days later. I've been a nurse here at Mercy since 2018, and my first home unit was the very wing that he was a patient on. His ambulance drove from our hometown in Huntsville past two closer hospitals, all because he wanted to be at Mercy. The kindness that was shown to my family started in the emergency room. I contacted a respiratory therapist who just happened to be working that day. She was able to give the doctors and nurses accurate information on him before he had even arrived by ambulance. I know he was scared. I was. And he was met with staff that referred to him as Amy's dad. And I know that had to make him feel a sense of home. Then on Christmas week, I worked two floors down from Dad and I was unable to see him due to safety reasons. There was never a conversation with any provider that I didn't ask to see him. I knew it hurt them to tell me no, but it hurt me more to think that I didn't try. The providers would come to me while at work to update me. Even with the mask on, I could see their sadness. One physician told me that she had never taken care of someone with COVID that was family to a friend. The chaplains always stopped to see me at work. They just wanted to see how I was and if I needed anything. One frequently offered to tell Dad how much we loved him and pray with him as he made his way down to the rooms in the COVID unit. I worried that the staff didn't know my dad. I mean, did you really know that he was named the nicest man in Madison County? There he laid, completely sedated, and no one knew him. His chart said Gary, and I knew that he would never respond to that name. I began writing a Facebook post every day, and it was directed to the staff at Mercy that cared for him. I started it with, "If you are taking care of Gary Bollinger in room 407, he goes by Butch." And it ended every day with, "Remember, he loves Jesus and he will always accept a prayer." I always gave them something to talk to him about, as though he could talk back. But while they were in the room caring for him, I wanted him to be reminded of all the things that he loved and the people that loved him. He was a cowboy, a saddle maker, fan of rodeo, a preacher, and a husband, dad, and poppy. The number of emails that I received from COVID nurses, aides, respiratory therapists, monitor techs, dialysis nurses, the list goes on, that just wanted to say that they were praying for him and my family. They would express their desire to see him and talk to him. The entire staff went above and beyond for him on a daily basis. I remember as we were getting closer to the end of his stay, I had a call from a friend at work on her day off. I was explaining to her that they were my eyes and I just needed to know where we were at with his recovery. She asked if a nurse that was working could call me and tell me what things really look like. I didn't know this nurse, but I always recognized her by name. She started the conversation with, "He isn't going to make it, Amy." What a hard and honest truth. I feel like they all saw the agony of Dad's family, and they knew him by reading my social media post. They felt a connection to a man that they had never met. Through his My Mercy account, I watched his labs very closely. I saw the need for dialysis become apparent, and I knew we were getting close to losing him. The day before he died, through a post, I asked if anyone would go into his room and play two songs for him. I knew that if he heard those songs, he would know that we loved him and that it was okay to stop fighting. A nurse messaged me a few hours later to let me know that she had played the songs for him and she had played them loud so he could hear them over all of those machines. My family was so thankful for the act of this one nurse. On December 27th, I received a call just after the morning lab had resulted. It was from the night shift nurse. He called to let me know that he felt like we would lose him that day, and he wanted me to be prepared. Later that morning, a physician called and said that we were welcome to come to the hospital and be with Dad. When we arrived and sat in the waiting room, a chaplain just happened to walk by. He could tell that we were in need, and he stopped and prayed with us. The house supervisor led us to the door of the unit, where we were met with the unit manager who helped us get our PPE on. As we walked down the hall, there wasn't an empty room. The doctor came in and he updated us and gave us time alone. He was prone and he had been for days. And every time that you tried to turn him, his blood pressure and his oxygen would drop. I've been a nurse a long time. And as a nurse, I had no idea what lying prone would do to a person until the nurses had me prepared. We held his hand and we talked to him. We were in the room for less than 30 minutes and his heart stopped. The doctor came in and spoke about how he knew at that moment Dad was entering heaven. I could see how sad he was that another patient had been lost to COVID. We left the room and so many familiar faces were in the hallway waiting for us. And I could tell that all of them were grieving the loss with us. I know COVID has taken its toll on the staff in the COVID unit and the entire hospital. As soon as one person passes, you have a patient in the ER waiting for that bed. The frustration is enormous, and it's a burden for you to bear. Just know that you are creating a bond with each of those families, even if it's just during a phone call. You are making a difference in the lives of the patients and everyone that they're related to. Don't grow discouraged. I know as a family member that lost a patient on the COVID unit, I will never forget your kindness. My dad was a jail chaplain for 13 years, and he preached every week. He never wanted to know why they were in jail. He just wanted to make a difference in their lives while they were there. I see each of you facing this never-ending battle with COVID in a very similar way. Your compassion for the patients and their families is ultimately to make a difference in the lives while they're in your care. You are a great success at this. My coworkers donated funds and wanted to do something for my family. We asked that they feed the COVID unit in his memory. Then the sales rep from Abbott came along and he wanted to pay for it. We were asked once again, what do we want to do for the money that was donated? We asked for Gideon Bibles. I delivered hundreds of Gideon Bibles to the chaplains here at Mercy. In each Bible, it says that it's in memory of Butch Bollinger in room 407. This family loves and prays for you and your strength every day. Thank you will never seem like enough for each of you.